So the language bioprogram hypothesis is a hypothesis proposed by this fellow, Derek Bickerton, that was trying to understand what allowed for the kind of amazing capacity that we see for language creation when we see the development of Creoles, when we see the development of home sign, and the development of Nicaraguan sign language. And his idea is that that capacity for innovating, for adding complexity, for creating something that wasn't there in the environment, is the same general capacity that underlies language acquisition even in typical environments where there is a fully formed language system for kids to learn. The idea with the language bioprogram hypothesis is that humans have innate knowledge about the structural properties that human languages have. This is innate language-specific, domain-specific knowledge, and it gives them that head start that they need to take messy signal from the input and create something structured and well-formed and systematic out of it. Now, this idea that the head start that they get is innate domain-specific knowledge is in accord with the generativist or the linguistic nativist approach to language acquisition. Now, not everybody is a fan of this, so for your non-linguistic nativists, right, those who do not believe in innate knowledge, like this lady here, Elizabeth Bates, did not believe in innate knowledge that's specifically linguistic, they say, yeah, we're totally with you that it's innate knowledge that's giving these kids a head start, but it may be innate stuff that's not specific to language. It could be, you know, certain types of statistical learning abilities, which are domain general. You can use them across cognitive domains. It could be certain types of pattern analysis abilities, right? And that these things might differ between children and adults. And that's why it's children who have the capacity for language creation that seems to be very different from what adults do, right? So there is actually quite a bit of support for differences between child and adult generalizations, depending on how consistent the input is or the quantity of input that is experienced, right? Children may do different things than adults. And you know, it's not, and so the response again to the language bioprogram hypothesis is that whatever they're doing, sure, it's innate, but it's not specific to language. It's non-linguistic abilities that are innate, that are allowing this capacity for language creation that we see.